Well, hello there, you awesome people on YouTube. How in the heck are you? What is today's date? Friday, November 11th. It's about 30 minutes past 1 o'clock. We are at the old President Broadwater Golf Course, or the remains of it. This is one of those properties that Katrina tore down, or blew down, destroyed, and it's been like this ever since. And all the sand is from when they clean up the beach. The machines that they use, they clean up the beach. They just come out here and dump it. I guess this is now a dump site. And this used to be a beautiful property. We'll go over to the clubhouse where it used to be in a little bit. I just want to show you what, how you Google any golf course and compare it to what I'm showing you here. And this is how far this place has come. I do believe these are little raccoon tracks. Let me know what you think they are. Maybe they're little dog tracks, I don't know. I do think they have a lot of wildlife out here. Raccoons, possums, herons, Canadian geese, hawks. And I'll come out here and just do some filming. I don't like to get away from the vehicle too much. People, they'll bring their dogs out here without a leash on, and I'm not talking about your little Yorkie terriers. I'm walking two big old German shepherds, and a little bit scary when they run after you. The door is open. The door is ajar. Yeah, it's just this is overgrowth since Katrina hit, like a jungle out here almost. You know, back in the day, this place used to be, the old golf course just used to be amazing, beautiful piece of property. But none anymore. And, old clubhouse. I can get to it. That's where it used to be, right there. This is they've dumped so much sand from the beach. I can't get back there anymore, but as my truck starts rolling down the hill. Preparation. That's what I'm known for, buddy. Preparation. Thought somebody was creeping up on me in my dang truck rolling down a little hill. Yeah, all this is beach from the sand. Beach from the sand? Sand from the beach. And, yeah, they just bring it out here and dump it. Ton of tracks out here. Tracks. I'm going for a raccoon. Hey, yeah, this area right here used to be the clubhouse. When they in the clubhouse, they had a little bar set up, and you could order food. It's just like any other golf course clubhouse. pretty, and all back here is just overgrown. I could probably get my truck back there, but no, I'm not gonna do that today. Maybe another time. But here you go. This is what the old Broadwater, President Broadwater Golf Course looks like today. I see no tents back here. I was pretty sure there was gonna be some homeless tents back here. Homeless people with tents back here so they can get out of the weather. Because they don't have a place to stay, of course. Maybe I'll come back later and do some recon, see if I can get my truck out there. Golly. Note to self, Jeff, next time you come out, don't use your water shoes. Boots on, man. Boots are made for walking. Water shoes are made for watering. What a mess. Golly, unbelievable. I know the city has some more projects going on. I don't understand why we've got enough tore up property in Biloxi to renew, you know, make things better again here. I don't know why they don't rebuild what's been torn down. I mean, it's been like this since Katrina. What? I guess it's gonna be like this forever. Let me find my keys and get in this truck here. I can tighten up. So that's as far as I can go that I know so far. We'll take a drive out. Would really like to see with this property if somebody would invest the money is to make this a campground. Instead of having the rinky-dink campgrounds that we have out here, make something really nice. What in the world? I think somebody's thrown away a door. There's some more sand. You know, I know there's people in America that have money. I ain't one of them, but it's just an empty property. And good Lord, the last thing we need here is another dang dollar store or Dollar General. I don't know. Stop complaining, Jeff, and tighten up. And there's some more of the sand that the beach crew comes and just dumps out here, along with some other stuff. And up coming on the right is a nice little pond. Yeah. I have yet to been try to fish in there because it's hard to get to it. We're gonna leave the truck running. maybe it won't get hijacked. Got a pile of trash down there to the left. Look, but I'm amazed. Now, when the Canadian geese come out here, this whole pond area will be full of Canadian geese. What the hell is that? All right. I don't know how high that water level is, but the Canadian geese, this will be filled with Canadian geese. Beautiful. The only drawback is that when they come down here, the whole roadway and everything else will be filled with Canadian geese poop. And in that tree right there in the middle of your screen, the egrets will build nests in the springtime. The very top of the tree, they'll build their nest in those trees, in that tree especially, and raise up the babies. In the summertime, boy, it is murderously hot out here. Stick with me. I'm gonna take you down. Let me see if I can get down this way in the old truck without getting stuck. Woo. That's another shot of the lake. And here in the past, I mean, right now we're behind businesses. And I don't want the police to get called on me. But if they do, I ain't doing nothing wrong. I'll just apologize profusely. Another shot of another lake. Well, it's a bigger pond. And one day I'm gonna have to try. Literally, I've been here literally all my life. I've never tried to go. Well, I couldn't go fishing out here when the golf course was here, but. I don't see why they wouldn't have fish in that pond. They got butterflies out here. And this is the spot that I'll come to in the spring. And I take a shot into the sun there. That's the tree you were looking at across the way, in the tops of the trees there, the egrets will make their nest, and I come here and get some pretty good decent pictures. There's a little duck in the pond. I don't know how high this water level is. We're gonna stop it there. Anyway, here's a look at the pretty lake. Yep, it's peaceful out here. Well, come on, let's get out of here. So let me know what you think, if you're still watching by this time. What do you think would be nice out here, other than another golf course? If there's one thing Biloxi, Mississippi has, it is not a shortage of blighted properties and empty properties. Now we're gonna try to back up. Let's see what happens. See this mess? I get stuck. I want some donation. Yeah, super thanks are on, by the way. Made it. Woohoo! Be a nice place to camp. Maybe somebody should build a campsite out here. Imagine that trash. And in ending, since we like to focus on trash. There you go. And that reek of community pride, man. The frickin' door. And whatnot. Garbage. Trash. Filth. Well, it is what it is. Oh, we're gonna get out of here. Thank y'all for watching. I appreciate it. It's the Biloxi you don't see every day, as I take the parking brake off so I don't burn nothing up. And this was once the once a really nice place, but not anymore. All right, thank y'all for watching. Peace. Get outside, have some fun. Tighten up.